Which player will take the lead? Which player will secure a spot in the winner's finals? A best of five awaiting one of these winners.
Always, as the days go by and we get to the semifinals now, we get a little bit more of a read onto the meta. So, of course, Etowaru, recognizing that Yeonhong is a key battery to Matsu's composition, instantly locks it out.
Yep, Matsu on the left side, Etowaru on the right, and you called it, Yeonhong, the big one there. The Jaeger not pre-banned away by Matsu, so seems he's well aware that he's equipped to deal with it should it come out. He instead chooses to pre-ban out the Sierra, which was an avid pick for both of these players in their previous match. Matsu will secure the Molong first, and then the counter picks, Lulu and Carnal, coming out from Etowaru.
The Sierra pre-ban really just points out to me that Matsu came in knowing that he wanted to take the Molong. He didn't really care about Sierra this time around. But of course, we do see the stats on Fire Bison, and it is as stellar as always.
Yeah, 55% with that many games that you've been involved in, that's pretty solid. I mean, well over 50 matches, 60 games here for the Carnal and Fire and Bison. Meanwhile, we see that Fran being picked up as well by the Matsu, and then the Kaki. Six wins and 10 losses, actually a pretty low win rate here for Kaki.
The problem for Kaki has been that he hasn't been able to get enough damage down in turn one, and ever since then, he's been controlled down by the attack breaks coming out of Fran and etc. Of course, now we see Etowaru following up with the trusty old Jaeger and Diana, who's been just very powerful throughout the whole APAC preliminary.
Yeah, Diana has proven herself time and time again. Jaeger will be that relied pick by Etowaru. Now, Matsu, you left the Jaeger open quite intentionally. What is your plan? Looking at the Daphnis, we've seen it have some solid success before, and then the Antares as well.
More fire coming out despite Etowaru having only one win. We have seen a repetition of the strategy earlier, and it has worked out against Diana. So now the question is, will it work out again? And if you're Etowaru, you have to bring back some water like a Chow, like a Barbara. There's an arsenal of options available.
Yeah, we've definitely seen the monsters you mentioned, we've seen to some success. The Chow, probably not seen really at all here throughout the APAC preliminaries, but we've seen the Barbara have some great success. And now we're going to see the Water Druid being the pick up for Etowaru.
So Water Druid is going to be a fantastic counter to both Molong and Daphnis's nukes because he cuts in whenever an ally drops below the threshold HP amount. And of course, that's why we see it get banned out.
Yep, Abellio gets banned out. And then the Daphnis getting banned out by Etowaru doesn't want to deal with the potential massive nuke coming out from there. This is a best of three between these two players in Group D of the APAC preliminaries.
So now we are looking at the attack bars, and the Lulu and Friends is very fast, which is very concerning. And now Diana, of course, is going to be going for the shield here now, trying to protect the Jaeger from the onslaught of damage.
Yeah, just going for a little bit more protection for Etowaru. The Jaeger was brought down already so low by that Molong.
Oh.
And now the heals, and then potentially another heal coming out from Lulu and Friends as she secures another turn.
It's a given rule at this point that if Lulu gets two heals off, a unit's going to be full HP regardless of what HP was at previously. Now, Carnal, of course, can't get much done given Fran's buffs on the side of Matsu, so he's going to have to wait a couple turns.
Yeah, both sides really kind of well prepped for these first turns. They'll be able to kind of pass it through and now have to wait for another opportunity as more damage coming out against Jaeger once again.
Now we are looking at a potential justice out of the Jaeger. It is going to do a decent amount, and we see that it is a violent Jaeger, not on Vampire, but that does mean there will be a lot more damage coming out of Etowaru.
Yes, a lot of damage, and of course still has a support from the Lulu. The Antares does secure a turn here, cuts in.
Right, the Antares is proccing the passive a fair amount, constantly moving in. But of course, the revenge out of Jaeger is going to be very painful. So now Fran has to cleanse all those debuffs away and heal Antares back up.
Yeah, the Jaeger brought down very low defense break there as well. Lulu gets a turn, but doesn't have her skills two or three.
This is scary because now Kaki is going to move, and there's no way for Etowaru to interrupt the Kaki. And of course, we are seeing the potential skill two, skill one angle from the Kaki, looking for the chop and the chop.
Gets the job done. The Jaeger now out. A huge Thorn pulled out by Matsu as he leads four monsters to three against Etowaru here. Sword Rain does finally come out with an angle. Only gets one stun, but the Antares locked down quite low.
But the stun on Taurus is pretty huge because that makes Diana a lot more comfortable now with transforming. The Dragon Stance coming out, but was unable to grab a lot of advantage because there was no stun. And we see Etowaru still playing very passive, going for the shield instead.
Yeah, still wants to just make sure that he can secure this long fight. We'll see if that pays off, though, as he's already at a numbers disadvantage. Cocky slashing away, gets rid of the shield. There's a defense break as well. Though Long starting to chip down. Antares now living, and a sliver of health gets eliminated.
Right, so that finish off was very crucial for Etowaru because Fran was locked and loaded with the heal. So now we are sitting on a 3v3, but Fran with a fantastic Violent proc is going to be able to provide that attack buff for Cocky. Of course, Lulu has a cleanse of her own, but if Cocky armor breaks with skill 1, it could get dicey.
Yeah, use the skill 3 right away, but you call it, Peter. There's the defense break coming out from Cocky and a lot of damage too. Reckless Assault on top of the Diana, and she goes down immediately. And that not able to be saved right there.
At this point, it is going to be a 2v2. It's funny because we mentioned that Fran and Lulu are kind of like the rivals when it comes to healers. But now there's another rivalry going on. Cocky with raw damage, and there is Carnal for the CC. Will CC come out on top or the damage?
Yeah, I mean, so far the damage looking strong, but of course Lulu, it's like they're perfect counters right now against each other. You have more damage on the side of Cocky, but more heals coming out of the Lulu, and now the control from Carnal keeps the Cocky locked down for just a little bit.
But the problem is that if you don't lock down the Lulu as well, the Purify is there, looking for the armor break now, always landing it on the second hit, so he's not getting the boost in damage so far, as we see actually now Lulu dropping real low.
Yeah, the Fran is in danger right now, has that slow attack speed as well. And
huge.
The Cardinal with the correct targeting right now. Etowaru seems to know exactly what he has to do. He's feeling pretty comfortable. He still goes for the heal, protects the Cardinal, and still gets another proc to hit against the Fran.
Etowaru absolutely needs to keep this Fran locked down because the damage out of Cocky is stacking up. Unfortunately, there was no provoke out of Cardinal in the previous turn, so now the attack buff is here. Even if Cardinal takes out the Fran now, she has done her last move, basically the dying kiss, and now it's set up the Cocky.
Oh.
The damage is crazy with the attack buff.
Huge, skill 3 comes out, but only up to half health now, and now another heal coming up for Fran. She's all the way topped back up. Sword Rain trying to do what it can. The attack speed slow onto Fran once again, but you called it, Peter. The attack buff was enough for the Cocky to finish the job. And Lulu now just trying to hang on to try to see if they can drag out this game, but I don't think it's gonna happen.
I also don't think it's gonna happen. Etowaru just needs to give it up because Cocky is going to get only stronger and stronger. And this is why I mentioned that Cardinal really had to keep the Fran locked down. Just one turn that he missed the provoke and the match got completely turned around and the win goes over to Matsu.
Matsu brings it home in game number 1 and the Fran-Cocky combo comes out on top in that intense 2v2 towards the end of game 1. Matsu leading 1-0 in this best of 3.
Matsu is just here today to show us a flawless record, hoping to keep on that 2-0 victory, and taking in that advantage right on round 1 is a great way to do that.
Yeah, Matsu really showing his prowess here in that first game. It looked like things might get a little dicey as they were trading back and forth, but correctly identifying how to take out that Igor as soon as possible, gets the job done, and then he's able to continue. And of course, I mean, having that Antares also kept the Diana so passive throughout the whole game, perhaps making a huge mark against Etowaru's game plan.
Right, absolutely. A great point by Chobra. It bought enough time where Cocky was able to truly shine. And of course, now, if you're Etowaru, you just got really heavily punished for the Diana pick, so you have to be a lot more wary now and consider picking it later on in the draft rather than early.
Yeah, see if you can maybe circumvent that a little bit as we saw the pre-ban. So Jaeger this time does just get pre-banned right away. Still doesn't want to have to deal with it 2 times in a row. And the Molom being pre-banned out against Matsu. The Reckless Assault, of course, very, very scary to kick things off with. So the Sierra first pick returns now for Etowaru.
Sierra first pick. This is a unit that we have seen the win rate a little bit lower on the 40% side, but we know that she is still very good. So it is going to be a very strong, secure. And of course, now we see Matsu returning with one of his trusty old combos in the Yunhong.
Yeah, the Yunhong now not able to be pre-banned, so does get
wow.
picked up. 5 wins, only 2 losses. Very, very successful win the monster shows up here in SWC 2021 in the APAC preliminaries.
Of course, when you have that few little games, each loss really hurts. So Matsu, if he wants to make his favorite unit shine, he's got to show us what he's capable of with that Yunhong. As we see the Kaki now being picked up by Etowaru, he says, you know what? That unit was an absolute star of last game. Now I want to use him.
Yep, takes the Kaki and also picks up the Lulu as well. Of course, the Fran was already picked up by the Matsu, so not able to make that pair with the attack buff. Now Daphnis coming out for Matsu, and the Water Marshal Cat returns. We'll see if it's able to live through the draft this time around.
Matsu, he really likes Mina, and he feels that it is a very strong pick in the meta, and I do agree. Whenever I play Siege or Guild Wars myself, I often find myself bringing Mina, especially into Kaki, because she is fantastic at grabbing the 1-2-3 punch, and it brings down Kaki low enough to go for the kill angle.
Yeah, we've seen that damage firsthand last week in Group C of the APAC preliminary, mm-hmm. So we'll see if it can happen here as we see the rounded out picks for Etowaru. We see the Wind Heart Magician and then Kinky as well.
So Kinky is the late game insurance for Etowaru, looking for that comeback. And of course, Triana is going to be a very good way to deal with the nukes out of Daphnis, not out of Mina, however, because she does have the multi-hits, which goes through Triana's passive. So it is going to be very interesting to see how Matsu plays around this Triana defense.
Okay, so Juno comes out for Matsu as the last pick. Now, we talked about Juno a little bit in situations, and I'm starting to think, Peter, maybe this one's not one of those good situations.
Yeah, I agree with you, Chobra. Juno doesn't bring too much value this game outside of having an elemental advantage on Sierra and Triana, because there's not too many buffs coming out of Etowaru besides Triana skill 2 and Lulu skill 3 and skill 2. So Matsu really needs to show us that his Juno is different. It is built on such a high amount of damage, and he is looking for the Mina cleanup onto Kaki through Triana's passive.
Okay, all eyes on Mina, it looks like, as we see that Daphnis and the Kinky banned out. We have Matsu leading 1-0 in the winner semifinals here in Group D of the APAC preliminaries. This is game number 2.
Now we have Yunhong to set up some of the attack bar gains for Matsu. The strip is going to miss, meaning that there is now no longer attack bar gain. So now, if we take a look, it seems like Mina is definitely going to be struggling to get a move on. So now Sierra looking for the Fate of Destruction, but it shouldn't be enough to kill.
Yeah, just puts the bomb onto the Yunhong. We'll see what the plan is here. Do you go for the detonate right away, considering it, and does go for the skill 3. Lots of damage and a stun onto the Yunhong.
Definitely a lot of damage right now. Juno looking for the attack buff damage, going for the skill 1 on Kaki instead. And we see that the Kaki is ruined on very tanky stats. So now it is going to be a matter of wonder. Can Mina have enough damage with the chain attack?
That is a lot of damage, but not able to finish the job just yet. Kaki goes down quite low.
Fortunately, the Yunhong is still alive for Matsu. You definitely don't want her to go down very easily, because one of her main strengths comes from the fact that she is so good at sustaining herself, but it will not happen this time.
Yeah, Sierra is able to finish the job. Meanwhile, Lulu had healed up the Kaki quite a decent amount. More sustain coming out from the Triana as well.
So now, because the attack break got cleansed, Mina has the 3 or the 2 crit angle, which is not enough to go through Triana's passive. So now we are seeing the Triana passive grabbing so much value for Etowaru.
Yeah, just keeping that Kaki alive for that one extra turn, that might be all they needed, as another bomb comes out, this time onto the Mina. And while we had all eyes on Mina, she's not able to really secure the win yet for Matsu.
Of course, the heal out of Fran is going to be huge and buy a lot of time for Matsu, but we saw that the Fate of Destruction is now only a turn away. Triana's passive only a turn away as well. So Matsu really needs to get something done, but there's another proc, and Triana has passive up yet again.
Oh my goodness, that is a pain. You're trying to work around it in whatever ways you can, but Matsu not able to find the right timing just yet. Juno doing what she can, putting the dots on 3 members.
And there is the Fate of Destruction we talked about. Sierra doesn't even need to land it on Mina, because the skill 1/skill 3 will be enough of an AoE damage output to take out the Mina. And now at this point, Matsu needs to show us. You know, we questioned the Juno pick. We said it wasn't a very stellar moment, but now he's got to prove himself.
Yeah, I mean, this is, if you are able to win this, you prove everything for Juno ever, I would say, in this 1v4. I mean, so much sustain on the side of Etowaru. Yeah, it's not looking so good. There's the CG out, and Etowaru will be able to bring it back. Ties it 1-1 in game 2 of this best of 3.
Etowaru, he was definitely able to outclass his opponent in the draft this time around. The Triana was there to grab so much value. He banned correctly. And also, Etowaru just recognized that Juno was not a huge threat for him, so he just left it alone till the end, and it worked out great.
Yeah, not really fazed by that Juno. Doesn't get, you know, shaken or thrown off his track. And Etowaru able to play his own game plan of keeping that Kaki, keeping that Sierra able to continue the pressure against Matsu. Now tied 1-1. We return to the pre-bans of game number one. Sierra and Yunhong will be pre-banned out, and we'll see how each player adapts in this draft. The winner will move on to the winner's finals for a chance to secure that first spot into the APAC Cup from Group D.
Of course, when you have match point for both players, the pressure is going to be stacked very high for both players. And in the first round where we had the pre-bans of Sierra and Yunhong, Matsu was able to secure the win. So now Etowaru needs to bring in a bit of a switch up in the strategy and somehow find the kryptonite to Matsu.
Yeah, I mean, so far it's looking exactly the same. Now this is the same point where Etowaru previously brought out the Diana and then got countered by the Antares and really wasn't able to play actively. We'll see if Etowaru changes things up in his picks here in this round.
We are waiting on the timer now. Of course, Matsu is there with the Molong Kaki Fran. It has brought so much damage for Matsu, and it's worked out great. So Etowaru, he's got, of course, the trusty old Molly and Jaeger. But right now, I'm wondering, will Etowaru return to the Triana last pick? Because that unit has seen a bit of a, you know, a shaky result. But when it's worked out, you know, it worked out very nicely against the damage.
Yeah, I mean, that the passive is so huge when it's able to work out. A Jaeger we have not seen too often. Sitting at, you know, just about halfway through, 3 wins, 2 losses. We'll see how that pans out for Etowaru. The Icarus being considered alongside the Molong. And then we see the water on Amusha as well. Just all the damage now being piled on top of the Fran to round things out for Matsu. Matsu has shown his hand. Etowaru, how do you respond?
You just got, you know, be caught off guard when you see the double Onimusha coming out. Suiki is obviously going to be a very strong addition of damage for Matsu. So now Etowaru, instead of going for the Triana, brings in a super carry in the Diana. So now Etowaru, if you banned the Kaki, you would have had a free reign on Diana. But Etowaru was very smart, realizing that Diana could get banned out, so he took out Molong instead.
Yeah, doesn't want to all in on that choice. Still bans out the Molong. Don't want to deal with that Molong and Chris combo. This is match point to decide who goes on to the winner's finals between these two players in Group D of the APAC preliminaries.
We saw Matsu saving that skill 3 out of his Icarus because he knew that he can't get the kill done anyways, it seems, since the Lulu is here to cut in, and she's just going to be healing up whatever damage Kaki did.
All right, so the sustain very clearly set up on the side of Etowaru. I mean, this seems to be a spear and shield situation here between these two players, as we see the setups potentially. Karnal not having a window right now to do anything.
Etowaru tried to strip away the attack buff from Kaki, but it did not work out. We see Suiki piling the damage now, trying to set up for the Icarus skill 3, and we've seen that Etowaru's Jaeger is on Violent, not Vampire, so he doesn't have any sustain left. We're looking at an angle for Dark Recovery.
Oh, and it's not able to finish the job, but he does secure another turn, and while the Jaeger did answer back, Icarus now looking to see if he can do anything, not going to have enough damage, so he decides to target, switch targets a little bit. Doesn't want to risk the revenge here from the Jaeger.
Matsu, he knows that the Kaki was about to move next, so he's going to go for the Blade Slaughter, and the damage is there to take out Jaeger.
Yeah, finishes the job against Jaeger, and now suddenly Etowaru, you're looking like you're lacking a lot more damage than you did at the beginning of this round.
You have two, some of the greatest supports in the game in sustain, but you know that when you have a lot of sustain, you need the damage follow-up, and Karnal is not that. Of course, Suiki with the elemental advantage is going to have a really easy time landing those defense breaks, and Etowaru has a lot to prove right now.
Yeah, Matsu, I mean, the setups right themselves here between the two Onimushas. Icarus already did their job as well. Karnal doing what he can, trying to bring down this Fran, but is that really going to be enough? Kaki now putting on his own defense brace as well. A lot of damage now expected from the Suiki. Swipes through, not able to finish off the Carnal just yet.
Not enough, but you love seeing the huge damage come out, especially out of such a cool skill. And now Molly is trying to buy time with the shield and cleanse, and there's a provoke out of Carnal, but the problem is, the second Icarus gets skill 3 available, it could get very scary for Etowaru.
Yeah, I mean, as long as he can just keep him not at full health, the Icarus should be able to finish the job. Lulu doing what they can to try to top off Carnal, the Molly as well through the passive. Now Sword Rain does have an angle.
Sword Rain, definitely a skill that is not too consistent with landing the debuff. So now Etowaru looking for the skill 2 first. Sword of Gluttony grabbing the attack bar, but now Icarus, does she have the angle? I say no, because Lulu's about to move.
Yeah, the attack bar correctly identifying that from Matsu, doesn't take that risk. And so just passes through the turn for now, trying to bring the Carnal back down. But these heals are really piling on for Etowaru.
At this point, Molly is exposed. So Matsu was thinking along the same lines as me, looking for the armor break angle onto the Molly. And now we have Molly at around 40, 60% HP. And it seems like Icarus just didn't have enough.
Yeah, not enough there. So more heals coming back out. And these sustains are really doing what they can. The two supports trying to keep this fight alive. Fran finally able to get the buffs back online for the team.
Attack buff means it gets so much scarier. And now there's the dark recovery. At this point, Matsu looking so strong with the double Onimusha.
Matsu takes the win off the back of the double Onimushas, off the back of that Fran. And of course, the Icarus as well getting the job done onto the Jaeger early on, just bringing him down so low, allowing the setup for the Kaki to finish the job. Matsu wins 2-1 to move on to the winners finals in Group D.